Entrance antiphon: God, who raised Jesus from the dead, will bring our mortal bodies to life again because of his Spirit dwelling within us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, coming together as God's holy family, today our servite order, we remember the life of all the deceased of servants of Mary, and also we remember the life of Saint Elizabeth the Hungary. We pray that through Saint Elizabeth's intercession, we may serve God and love one another as we love ourselves. And let us now pause for a moment. We acknowledge our sins, and so we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most gravest fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Lord God, you are the glory of your servants, our deceased brothers and sisters, parents, relatives, friends, and benefactors, shared in the same baptism and were joined to the death of Christ on earth. May they now share in the glory of his resurrection in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard the Lord saying to me, to the angel of the church in Sardis, write this. The one who has the seven spirits of God and the seven stars says this. I know your works, and that you have the reputation of being alive, but you are dead. Be watchful and strengthen what is left, which is going to die, for I have not found your works complete in the sight of my God. Remember then how you accepted and heard. Keep it and repent. If you are not watchful, I will come like a thief, and you will never know at what hour I will come upon you. However, you have a few people in Sardis who have not soiled their garments. They will walk with me dressed in white, because they are worthy. The victor will thus be dressed in white, and I will never erase his name from the book of life, but will acknowledge his name in the presence of my Father and of his angels. Whoever has ears ought to hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To the angel of the church in Laodicea, I write this. The Amen, the faithful and true witness, the source of God's creation, says this. I know your works. I know you see neither cold nor hot. I wish that you were either cold or hot. So because you are lukewarm, neither hot or cold, I will spit you out of my mouth. For you say, I am rich and affluent and have no need of anything, and yet do not realize that you are wretched, pitiable, poor, blind, and naked. I advise you to buy from me gold refined by fire, so that you may be rich, and white garments to put on, that your shameful nakedness may not be exposed, and buy ointment to smear on your eyes, so that you may see. Those whom I love, I reprove and chastise. Be earnest, therefore, and repent. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, then I will enter his house and dine with him, and he with me. I will give the victor the right to sit with me on my throne, as I myself first won the victory and sit with my Father on his throne. Whoever has ears ought to hear what the Spirit says to the churches. The word of the Lord. I will seat the victor beside me on my throne. He who walks blamelessly and does justice, who thinks the truth in his heart and slanders not with his tongue. I will seat the victor beside me on the throne. Who harms not his fellow man, nor makes up a reproach against his neighbor, by whom the reprobate is despised, while he honors those who fear the Lord. I will seat the victor who lends not his money at usury and accepts no bribe against the innocent. He who does these things shall never be disturbed. Alleluia. God loved us.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
God loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, Jesus came to Jericho and intended to pass through the town. Now a man there named Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector and also a wealthy man, was seeking to see who Jesus was. But he could not see him because of the crowd, for he was short in stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree in order to see Jesus, who was about to pass that way. When he reached the place, Jesus looked up and said, Zacchaeus, come down quickly, for today I must stay at your house. And he came down quickly and received him with joy. And when they saw this, they began to grumble, saying, he has gone to stay at the house of a sinner. But Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, behold, half of my possession, Lord, I shall give to the poor. And if I have extorted anything from anyone, I shall repay it four times over. And Jesus said to him, today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a descendant of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save what was lost. The Gospel of the Lord. Today, Jesus shows us that every person is worthy in the eyes of God. God chose us first to become children of God, not the other way around. Salvation has come to Zacchaeus' house because he was able to open his soul and heart to repent and to make a room for God and others. His meeting with Jesus changed everything. He came to realize that Jesus is calling him not to be number one or not to be great, but Jesus is calling him to be merciful and to be humble with others and to treat everyone as Christ with love and kindness. We are called to do the same. Our Lord Jesus has showed us the path to follow him, and his path is very simple. Take up our crosses, open our hearts to the call of repentance, and allow him to shepherd us through life. Amen. We trust in our merciful God. We lift up our prayers and petitions for the church. May God continue to bless her in her work of proclaiming the good news. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who live in chronic illness, may God's infinite love strengthen them. And for recently sick, our pastor, Father Dennis Cris, Derek Brebisca, Graciela Fernandez, Mercedes Robledo, and particularly those with COVID-19 virus, for Fernando Rodriguez and Eduviges Rodriguez, for them, we pray to the Lord. That for those who have died, that God will welcome them into the light and joy of God's presence forever. Especially for those names are in our memory garden, and for those who have died from COVID-19 virus, especially we pray for Harold Spurgeon. For them, we pray to the Lord. And today's Mass is being offered to pray and to remember for the repose of the soul of Palmira Tafani. For her and her family, we pray to the Lord. And for the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Graciously, Lord, we need your mercy and grace for our lives each day. We ask that you hear and answer the prayers we bring before you today. Through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, receive the sacrificial gifts and prayers that we offer to you for all the members of our family who have been united with us by bonds of religious life or love. Graciously grant to them the reward promised to your faithful servants through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you, and lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. As the destroyer of sin and death, Christ enables his disciples who live in love and conquer by grace to eat from the promised tree of life. As the Lord who has died for his servants, he prepares a place for them in your house where Our Lady reigns and her servants rejoice. As the merciful judge who will come to the end of time, he carries to heaven his brothers and sisters, born to new life, where there will be true freedom, a lasting treasure, and undying love. Therefore, we too, with all the angels, praise you, and in joyful exultation, gladly acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took the bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. we proclaim. And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs and to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And together we say the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, thy kingdom come. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us now offer to each other the sign of Christ's peace. Peace with you. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord. On behalf of our brothers and sisters who are right now watching us at this Mass, who cannot receive the Holy Communion, and let us remember them and pray for them the prayer of the spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we are filled with the life-giving energy of the sacraments. We humbly ask that by the strength of this sacrifice, all the deceased members of our family may be citizens of the eternal kingdom with our glorious Lady, to whom they dedicated their lives of service through Christ our Lord. Due to the announcement of the governor yesterday, starting tomorrow, all our masses will be outdoors in St. Joseph Plaza. This pertains to all weekday and all weekend masses. And please note that when you are attending the outdoor mass, please bring your own chair for safety and health reason. Our chairs will not be available from the classrooms. And thank you for your understanding and cooperation during these challenging times. So starting tomorrow, our mass at 8:30 mass will be in St. Joseph Plaza. The Lord be with you. And may the Lord bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.